We'll actually go through a true mock game scenario, travel to the team hotel tomorrow, and then perform a game operations on Saturday. Injury-wise, we're status quo. Vianney did not practice today. I'm hoping to get him back on Monday. We did not practice Daniel today. We're hoping that we gave him a cortisone shot that usually takes 2 days to be able to see how that works. But he had two really good days of work, Tuesday, Wednesday. Shut him down, give him a little bit of rest, and I think he'll be full speed come next week. He's really feeling good right now. So with that, I'll answer any questions that you got.
If you had a game Saturday, would you be quite ready to play, or are you kind of glad you got another?
No, I think with Vianney being out and Daniel being out right now, I'm thankful. You know, for us as coaches and players, this is new for us to have this extra week of training camp, and your body clock just feels like, okay, you just got done with week four. It's about time to play. So it's a little bit different for us, but thankful that we can get a couple guys that are just right on the edge of coming off the injury list. It's a good thing for us.
Was Daniel being off today, was that planned, or is that kind of in response to?
No, that was planned early in the week. We said that we were going to get Tuesday, Wednesday. Obviously, those are our heavy days, and then be able to give the cortisone shot, let him rest basically Thursday, Friday, be part of the walkthrough, just go through the walkthrough part of the session on Saturday, the mock game, and then be ready full speed next week is what we're hoping.
Is there any concern Daniel could have a reoccurring thing throughout the season? Or is
you always have that, but he's really feeling good. He felt good Tuesday and Wednesday. I think a little bit more it's kind of rubbing the rust off. You know, he didn't have a full spring, obviously an abbreviated training camp here. So he felt good enough to be able to go out there and get good quality work Tuesday and Wednesday, knock off some of that rust. I was happy about it. And then we're able to get a couple more days of rest before we got to go full speed here.
What is Vianney dealing with?
He's got a little bit of a foot injury, ankle injury, not the ankle he had in the spring, but the other one. And we just want to make sure that it's not a reoccurring thing. So we're being ultra protective. Obviously a guy that's been a 3-year starter going into his fourth year, he knows the playbook inside and out. So it's more important of getting him healthy and getting him ready to go. So he should be ready to go on Monday.
Has Daniel been able to just completely explode to where, he goes top?
Yeah, I think he's getting close. I don't think he's all the way there yet, but his 95% was faster than a lot of people's 100. So he looked good to me Tuesday and Wednesday. He felt good. He felt more confident. So it was good to get him in that live, format. And then hopefully, with a couple days off here and some medical attention, he'll be ready to go for next week.
You've got the situation where you don't necessarily want to run guys, rush guys back for mm-hmm. Western Michigan, but you don't want them not ready to go with Stanford the next week. I mean, you don't want mm-hmm. them to debut necessarily against Stanford. You have to balance that out between getting them some.
I look at Western Michigan as an extremely dangerous team. I mean, the more I study them, the more I study their personnel defensively, how many guys they got returning back on the defense. I'm like I said, I'm going to every game like it's a playoff game. Every game, we treat like a championship game. So we want every able body that we can to help us win that game. And that's going to be my approach the entire season. If you're able to help us, young and old, or being able to help us, if Daniel's able to help us, I know he's going to want to be out there. And we'll always protect a kid, always with our doctors. And I'd rather lose a ball game than hurt a kid. But if he's able to go and help us, he'll be out there.
Is someone like Daniel even more important, considering he's got good chemistry with Sam and you've got a younger or mm-hmm. less more inexperienced receiving group?
Yeah, well, I tell you, one of the things that I've seen that, you see a chemistry between him and Tyler. I mean, good Tyler going into his third year, and that's his guy also. And then the development of Kerry Angeline I've seen through camp with him and Sam being on the same page. Matter of fact, they threw a ball yesterday in 7-on-7 in a third down situation that you had to be on the same page, the timing of it. Sam had to have true belief that Kerry was going to be there. So to be able to have a Kerry Angeline, a Tyler Petit, and two young bucks, and you know, Josh Philo and Eric Cromanhope. We have a lot of tight ends right now that we feel very capable of doing the job. Even Austin Appleby, who had a good spring and fall camp. So, you know, I hope we get Daniel back. I think he's really close, but you know, if it's not, then it'll be next man up, and we're very confident in those guys that are around.
How much do you anticipate using the first teams on offense and defense in the game situation on Saturday?
Yeah, it's going to be mainly the first team O, first team D, but we're going against Western Michigan looks. This is a situational game day atmosphere where we're going to actually portray us playing Western Michigan from the service teams on offense, defense, and on special teams. It's going to help us gain some extra plays, extra work against what we're going to see. But also we're going to put our guys in substitution arenas where all of a sudden we have a three and out on offense and we've got to punt the ball. It's going to be as close to a game simulation as we can. It may not show the physicality of a real live game, but more the situational mastery of one from getting the right people on the field. And really for some young guys, understanding what it is to sit in a locker room and get ready at the college level, you know, our pregame routine, what we expect, and then going through a game and being able to hear the coaches coach on the sideline. We're going to have our coaches in the box on headsets. They're going to be going through their communication. So for us, it's the closest thing that we can portray to a game, just for us to work out our scenarios and situations.
Austin Jackson said he came in at 310 roughly, and he's down to 298. Is there a program that you get them on other than the strength and conditioning program?
Sometimes Coach Callaway can shed a couple pounds off you the way he practices. But it was neat to see Austin, you know, come. You know, when he came in, I think it was official visit, I think he was around 280, and then he walks in here at 310. He looks beautiful. But part of his game is his athleticism. And, you know, just to see him at 298 where he's at right now, he's moving extremely well. And that's one of the things that you see with young kids. You know, that a lot of times they come in and want to have the extra weight, but then they realize, wow, there's a lot of fast people on this field, and my movement skills are probably just as important as how big I am, if not more important. So he looks at a very comfortable weight right now, and we do that a lot through our strength and conditioning program, through nutrition. But also, you know, if you watch Coach Callaway's drills, he's going to get you in shape. Even you're going to come to camp at a particular weight, and it's going to come off. I even see Viotti. You know, Viotti is down to about 320 right now and looking really good, and that's from a really good camp and shedding about 10 pounds too.
What does it say? Andrew Boyes, one day is at right tackle, and then the next day he's at guard.
It's amazing, extremely intelligent, football smart kid that picks up the playbook very, very easily. He's a conceptual learner, which is very important when you're playing, you know, multiple positions. He's a kid that, you know, he's a student of the game. And because of his versatility to play inside or out, that raises your stock as a player. He's shown the versatility to play either position, the size to play guard, and the athleticism to play tackle.
One last one, anyone?
All right, this is one lighthearted. I haven't asked it because other people ask some questions, and there's probably no answer. But there's a ton of kids on this team, there's a dozen, who are juniors, thirds, and the fourths. I don't think there's a fifth. But way more than like the general population. You have any idea why?
I don't know. I'm named after my dad, Charles. He's Charles Kim. I'm Charles Clay. And, you know, so add me to the list. I think it's just part of our family culture that you have. And just we don't take that in the valuation of recruiting, but it just happens sometimes.
Okay.
All righty, guys. Thank you all so much.
Thank you.
Thank you. Thank you.